Hello, Internet, and people who are Internet adjacent, and those creeps standing behind you. My name is Wil Wheaton, and we are here in my game room today to unbox the third box that I curated for quarterly out of four quarters. Get it? It's a very clever and descriptive name. This box has items in it from the 90s, the third decade of my life on planet Earth. This box was extraordinarily difficult for me to curate. It was a real challenge. Unlike the 70s, which were very clearly defined for me by classic video games and like role-playing games and books, and the 80s, which were very easily defined by the Atari and Dungeons and Dragons, the 90s were this weird decade for me. I grew a lot during the 90s. I went from my 20s into my 30s, and I just had a really hard time pinning down where I was going to start. So I thought a lot about different things, and I expect that this particular box is going to be controversial. I think that it's probably going to elicit either a love it or hate it response from people who are into it, and I'll explain that as we go through it. What I eventually settled on was the early 90s, from about 1990 to about 1993, when I was heavily into the electronic dance music in Los Angeles, and particularly the all-night raves that we used to go to. I wanted to put some things in this box that would allow people to kind of like recreate that in sort of an interesting sort of way. And then there's also a couple of things in here that helped shape who I am. So let's get into the box. Of course, there is this delightful letter from me. The big thing that's in this particular box is the Hypno Cube. It is the Hypno Square from the Hypno Cube organization. This is 64 RGB LEDs, and it runs through all these different animated patterns, and it does this kind of light show kind of thing, which is great. I have the actual Hypno Cube from Hypno Cube, and I love it, and I was excited to get the square to add to that that sits in my office up in the house, but it's really neat. And a kind of a fun thing to sort of just like lose yourself in a little bit. We also included a Spotify password protected playlist of classic early 90s techno music. Things from like The Bouncer by Kicks Like a Mule, and a bunch of stuff from Alternate, some Fierce Ruling Diva. I basically went through Serious Beats Volume 3, which was my favorite techno record at that time, and figured out like what would go on that list. And then to help people figure out how to get the playlist, we made these super lo-fi rave flyers, right? And there's a phone number on here to call, and I made a recording that was just like back in the old days where you would phone up a number and then a person would tell you like what was coming up this weekend and like where to go buy your map and all that stuff. And it has the password for the Spotify playlist. So I just thought this was really silly, and I had a lot of fun putting this together. If you care about this sort of thing, I assembled this particular playlist while I was working on The Big Bang Theory. So a lot of this happened in my dressing room at Warner Brothers Studios. I also wanted to include a download of Woob's seminal genre-defining ambient record, 1194. This is one of my absolute all-time favorite ambient albums. I think it goes up with Earth to Infinity, which is really hard to find because they didn't license their samples, and the two Fax compilations. And I contacted Paul, who is Woob, and I said, hey, I'm a huge fan of your work. I know that you publish this stuff on Bandcamp. Could we maybe get some downloads or some physical CDs for people? And he was like, yes, we absolutely can. So this is an amazing, amazing record. It is a timeless record. I don't think dubstep is going to age very well, but this particular ambient style from the early 90s, I think is going to go and take its place next to art forms like jazz and other 20th century forms of expression. We also put in the Riff Tracks 1990s Cyber Thrillers free download. This was included because I loved Mystery Science Theater 3000. Congratulations on the successful Kickstarter. I've never been jealous of Felicia Day in my life until I found out she was going to be part of the show. But when Chris Hardwick and I were roommates in college, we got up every weekend to watch Mystery Science Theater. We watched every marathon. We videotaped the shows. Kids, ask your parents what a videotape is, and watched them over and over and over again. So it was Mystery Science Theater and Ren and Stimpy and Spike and Mike's Sick and Twisted Festival of Animation just like really shaped our sense of comedic timing and our sense of humor. And I got my friends at Riff Tracks online, and they said, yes, absolutely, we'll hook you up with a download. So it's real funny. It's 90s cyber thrillers. It's like the terrible Sandra Bullock one. I think it's called The Net, and a bunch of other stuff. It's super funny, and I really like it. And then finally, the last thing that we have in here is the 90s version of the Radio Free Burrito poster, which I really like because I would love it if you could design this poster so it looks like it was done like on someone's Mac Quadra who like had a super early version of whatever became Photoshop. So it's just like lots of weird colors and lots of weird shapes and stuff like that. And like, this is kind of the way we thought the future was going to look in 1990. Thank God we were wrong. I said in my letter that there's a lot of downloads in this, which I'm not crazy about. I feel like, oh man, you should get stuff, you know, you should get things you can put your hands on. But then at the same time, in the 90s, we always felt like the future was just about to happen. And a lot of it was living on the dial-up internet at the time. And if you had like a 28 baud modem, it was a big deal because things would load faster. And I do kind of like that in that like 90s sort of way, you have to go online to get some of these things. So, if you got this box, I really hope you liked it. And I'm really, really excited for the next box that I am putting together. It's going to be the last box, and it is going to be a 2000s box. And I don't know everything that's going to be in it, but there is absolutely going to be something homebrewing related in it, because that's what I've been doing in the 2000s, and I like it very much. So thanks for watching. You can go to quarterly.co/WIL. Anyway, thanks a lot, and I'll see you around. Bye.